I will be inserting life, swatching, and photos. I'll probably speed the swatches up just to make it a bit quicker because there's 12 nail polishes. These are not the only nail polishes I've bought recently. I will be doing another one of the most recent purchase I did from Pretty Serious, which was another 10 nail polishes. But first of all, I get into these ones here. So I picked up 6 new nail polishes from China Glaze. These are not new China Glaze, these are old China Glaze. Ones that I have been looking for a little while because I happen to like these particular lines from China Glaze. Not everybody does, but each to their own. So I have 3 from the Crinkled Chrome line and I have 3 from the Holographic line, which means I think I have 5 of the Holographic and 4 of the Crinkled Chrome. I will do the Holographic ones first. The first Holographic one I have is called OMG a UFO, which is a kind of like murky green Holographic. It's probably going to be really hard to see in the bottle, but it is in fact Holographic. And the thing I've noticed most is that these get more Holographic as they dry down. So when you first put them on, they don't look Holographic, and then they dry, and then they look Holographic. So I really like them. Went on. It was really, really weird, but when I shook it again and put another coat on, it didn't do it. It might have been the, I think it was actually the bluey green one.
Dun 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 d
The next one is called Wrinkling the Sheets, and it is a light greeny kind of colour. These have such an interesting texture. But then when you take them off, you realize that the bar glitters that are in them that look like they're the color of the actual polish are actually white. There's just so much polish around them that they appear to be that actual color. But they don't sit on top of the polish, they sit in the polish. So they're not, there's a little bit of texture, but not a huge amount of texture. If you don't like texture polishes, you really won't like these. You can put top coat on them. They still look really cool when you put top coat on them. I'll actually insert a picture where I used, I think it was the green one, it might be this bluish one, in a manicure, and I was actually wearing top coat over the top of it, but you can still kind of like see the texture of it because of the way that it's actually designed. So this kind of blue one is called Don't Be Foiled, and it does kind of have that slightly, because it's like a crinkled chrome, it does really have that kind of chromey look. Now I find with these, if you shake them up properly, you only need one coat with these ones. Holographic you need two, but these ones you really only need one coat, and if you have to go for that second coat, if you happen to mess up and need the second coat, they can look a little thick and chunky on the nail, which is not the best kind of look, so you're better off just doing it right the first time. You'll actually see that in the swatches before. I think it was with this blue one. I had to go back for a second coat and they kind of look chunky. The next six polishes are a special edition, limited edition, only in Australia, only for a very small number of people who pre-ordered polish collection from Angel Kiss Nail Lacquer, which is the creation of Alba. I'll leave her linked down below on Instagram. Angel Kiss Nail Lacquer was around for a little while. She's an Australian indie brand. Her stuff, I love her stuff. I have a whole bunch of her other polishes. She stopped making polish for a while, and then she really, really got the urge to make polish again. And she asked if anybody would be interested, to a few people on Instagram, like a group of us Australian nailies on Instagram, and I think the response she got was so overwhelming that she was like stunned because we all wanted it. So she made a collection of six polishes. Unfortunately, she was never able to ship outside of Australia because of their CSA and their stupid rules. We won't go into that. But those of us who are in Australia decided that yes, we definitely wanted her polishes. And so she came out with this collection. The majority of the collection is actually like pastel tones, like they remind you of ice cream type things. They're all foodie kind of related. This first one I'm going to show you is actually the darkest one in the collection. This is coffee fudge. It's a really dark brown with holographic and I think they're kind of coppery or browny type shimmers. It's really interesting and it's really beautiful on the nail. So it's one of those coffee fudge. Boom, boom, boom. Then we have the only cream in the collection. All the rest of them have shimmers in them. This one is the only cream. This is strawberry cream brulee. It is this baby pink color, like really soft baby pink. Really, really beautiful. Just a gorgeous color. So that was the only cream in the collection. Then we have this one, which is called Choc Mint, which of course is a minty kind of color, but it has, apart from having some holographic in it, it's got some, I think they're glass flecks. That's what it looks like, in it, that kind of give it sort of the look. We're not going to be able to see, you might be able to see in the swatch. Kind of makes you think a little bit of Choc Mint ice cream that has like the really tiny little bits of chocolate in it. It's kind of got that look to it, but it is super duper gorgeous. Then there is a blue, which again has, I think it's holographic, maybe it's just silver. Squints eyes, can't tell. The light in here is not the best. But this one is called Cotton Candy, and it's a light sort of baby blue with like all this shimmer in it. Really super pretty. Again, these are all super pretty, and the formula is like really nice. Then we have another one which I think has actually got the same glitters in it as Cotton Candy. This one is called Mocha Frosting. It's kind of a taupe colour. It's a little bit of separation there. That's because I haven't sugared up properly. Because I haven't swatched it. I haven't done the swatch videos for these. Did the swatch videos for those. Ask about face. Yeah. So this is kind of like a taupey colour with lots of shimmery bits in it. They might, I think they're actually holographic. I think it's supposed to be holographic, but it's more of a scattered holographic. I think these two are actually meant to be scattered holographics. And then we come to the one which is my favorite a lot because because it's like purple, but it's also a purple holographic. Seems to have a touch of linear holographic in it. This is sugar sprinkles. So it is a sort of light dusky purple with a very strong holographic. And it is beautiful. Just beautiful. So I know to keep doing more of those. And leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya.